50% of it means you need to receive the treatment. Once you participate fully, you will get 100% certification today. If you are social, if you want to check in, or like Ayana, Med Spa, I know if you like the page, Jamin will reward you with a special treat. And then if you're not my fan, well, I'm always looking for models or victims for my laser classes or microneedling. So that's how we stay connected. So I'm just going to go ahead and erase all this. Okay, so Beata Luberda. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and get started just with a little bit of introductions. And then if you don't have the Ayana menu in front of you, I have plenty up here. Okay? So good morning, everyone. My name is Beata Luberda Goodman. I've been an esthetician for 18 years, a nationally certified massage therapist for 15 years, and CEU instructor also for 18 years. Education is my passion. Before I got started in aesthetics, I did skin of a different kind. I sold leather for Wilson's and Berman's and Tannery West stores at Woodfield, Oak Brook, Golf Mill. And so retail is a very good experience if you have that, because 50% of your revenue in your aesthetic field should be service, and then 50% of it should be home care, retailing. Sell should not be a four-letter word, okay? And so I really want you to think of the opportunities of selling. Home care, because why should I spend an hour doing someone's facial if they're going to go home to dial soap and oil of Olay, and they're not going to maintain the results that you just spent an hour achieving? All right, so I worked at the fabulous Mario Tricocci Salon and Day Spa, and I focused on male skincare. I wanted to be a trainer for Mario, so I needed to be both a massage therapist and an esthetician, so I moved out to Salt Lake City, Utah, where I was exposed to 50 different types of massage modalities. Came back here to Chicago and was a trainer for the International Dermal Institute, Dermalogica. Have you heard of that product line? Okay. And so I had leaders in the spa industry come to the school to teach less stone therapy. Who's heard of less stone therapy? It's when you use the hot stones and the cold stones doing the facials and massages. Okay, so stone therapy, one stroke of the stone is equal to 10 strokes with the hands. It is that beneficial. And so I also had Eve Taylor from London, England, come and teach clinical aromatherapy. How many of you have heard of Chinese facial reading, Chinese facial diagnosis? When you look at someone's face and you could tell what's going on internally by what's reflected externally. So I had Ohashi come to my school. So I had leaders that I hosted. And so this is my passion. This is my passion, is doing education. I had the opportunity to work with Dr. Murad. And if you're an insomniac like me, you'll see the acne Murad complex kits 2-3 o'clock in the morning. You'll see the infomercials. But at the time, in my early 30s, I didn't have one or two breakouts. I had about 15, 20 pustules, papules, nodules, cysts. Who's going to listen to me about skincare when I clearly cannot manage what's going on here? And so I went to Ulta and I picked up one of those Murad Complex kits. And within 3 days, it changed my skin so much. I called Dr. Murad up in California and became his educator for 25 states. Okay? So I want you to think, once you get your license, there are so many avenues that you can do. Working for Murad was very exciting. I was single at the time, so I was traveling from Minnesota down to Texas and all the East Coast. And I was home 4 days a month, changing out my suitcase, and all I did was go to accounts that carried the Murad line. I met one woman here in Chicago. The last time I saw her at Dermalogica, she didn't speak any English, and I was putting together her 8-function steamer unit. The next time I saw her, she was a Murad account, and she was selling $30,000 a month just a myriad. Okay? So I want to know what she was doing that I wasn't doing. And that is resale license. Again, I'm going back to this whole sell, because once you have an aesthetic license, you have the power to have potent ingredients that's going to make a change in someone's skin. Okay? Anything over the counter at CVS, Ulta, Sephora, even Nordstrom's are not going to be as potent as the percentage and the pH levels that you have in your aesthetic license. We're going to talk about that this morning, okay? $30,000 a month. So think about retailing or getting your resale license, because let me tell you, this is how we make our money. And there's going to be a day, whether it's carpal tunnel or maybe I'm going to share an experience. I had 5 family members die of cancer in 1 year. And the last thing you want to do is put on a happy face and do a facial when your world is falling apart. And thank goodness I had my resale license, because that brought in the money to cover my mortgage, to keep me afloat. And I had that 7 days a week. And so I'm just saying that you need to make the most use of your licensure. Okay? No. So on state board, what would be the definition of free radical?
Angie said home breakfast.
Well, I only explained it that way.
The definition of a free radical is an unpaired electron. And this causes a cascade of mutation. It's going to keep causing premature aging until it finds a donor cell. A free radical is an unpaired electron. The only way to stop free radical damage is having an antioxidant donate itself, and it stops the cascade of premature aging.
That's how you get rid of the home
breakfast. There you go. It donates itself. Mm-hmm. I'll step in. Let's stop the damage. So free radicals cause the cascade of premature aging. What environmental factors do you know? We just talked about solar. So I'm going to put solar, sun, UVA, UVB exposure. Okay. Well, I need better markers. Okay, so let's do the sun. Solar. Smoking? Who said smoking? Okay, Lori. One puff of a cigarette sets off 1 million free radicals with each puff. And this is why a smoker's skin's going to look more sallow, more dull, more neglected, because those capillaries are the last ones that receive any benefit from your oxygen intake. A smoker's skin, you can tell on someone's face if they're a smoker. Number two, you'll see it, the stained. And number three, you will smell it, because I don't care how much mist they put in, it's still in their aura. Okay? So what else is something that causes free radical damage?
Just the environment,
so let's just say the environment. Mm-hmm. Hold your thought, Lori. We'll get there in just a moment. So when I lived in Utah, or you're going to go off, Brooke, to Colorado, right? The mountain elevation, any moisture is evaporated from the skin, okay? So definitely environment. If I used to work in a leather store, I would come home and I smelled like leather. If you work at a produce store, you're going to smell like fruits and vegetables. If you work in a restaurant, you're going to come home smelling like your work environment. Okay? So those are laminated on our skin. Okay, environment. So what else? What else? Specifically what? Okay. Well, did you say alcohol? So let's add to that Lori's comment about coffee and caffeine. Because these are going to be dehydrating to the body. Ladies, how much water are we supposed to drink a day? Half your body weight? Okay, I kind of like that. I mean, 8 glasses times 8 ounces is 64 ounces. That's great if you're 64 pounds. In massage therapy school, we were trained to drink 1 ounce for every pound you weigh. So this is 1 liter, and 1 liter is approximately 30 ounces. Let's just say on a good day I'm a 150. How many liters would I need to drink a day? 5. 5 is the magic number. So you know what? If you were an Olympic athlete, Lori, we would double that, because skin is the last organ that receives any benefit from all the water that we drink. Skin is the last organ. Okay, I'll give you something about Chinese facial diagnosis. The lips are correlated to your colon. The more dry, chapped, peeling someone's lips are, they're constipated. Because they need to have water to make a bowel movement. Okay? If you don't have water, you cannot do a bowel movement. All right? So in Chinese facial tech, when I see peeling lips, they need water, water, water. When we're doing our skin analysis and I lift the skin up and it looks like onion skin, crepey, dehydrated, skin is the last organ that receives any benefit from all this water, water, water. Okay? So we are hydrochemical electrical beings. Okay? Let's just say you were on spring break last week. You didn't water your house plants. You come home and the house plants are drooping. Okay? You give it a glass of water. Within 15 minutes, that hydrostatic pressure, and it resurrects itself again. We need water to keep going. Your brain is laminated in fluid. When you have too many alcoholic drinks the night before, you feel it, because what are you going to feel the next day? Don't talk too loud. I got a headache. I got a lot going on here. So you need to hydrate yourself. And then, you know, at the hairdresser, if you have a sensitive scalp, if you tug your hair and it hurts, you are dehydrated. Okay? So if you have a sensitive scalp, you need hydration. So that's a great tool to have. What is the best water for your body? I say, thank you. Spring water would be number one. Number two, the best water for your organs, the best water for your lymphatic, the best water for your blood, the best water for your organs is distilled water. Okay? Distilled water, and then we can even get into acid and alkaline, because all you got to do is put a slice of lemon in and you made it now in an alkaline environment. Okay? So if you're drinking coffee, you're dehydrating. So for every cup of coffee, you need to drink 8 more fluid ounces to flush out the caffeine. We are over-caffeinated. What happened, Lori?
I drink about 6 of these a day.
You're addicted. So, yeah. So what would happen if you didn't have a cup a day? You're going to have that headache. You're going to be going through that caffeine withdrawal. That's when you know you're addicted to the caffeine.
Oh, I know that.
There are people that live caffeine-free. True. It happens. Okay? So alcohol, caffeine. What else? What else do you think causes free radical damage? Who said that? Charlotte. What you eat. What the quality of food. If everything comes out of lean cuisine and you're microwaving it, you might as well be eating cardboard, because what nutrition? You just radiated. Okay? So once upon a time, food was all organic. The tomatoes that you grow in your backyard never will taste like what you have to buy at the grocery store. Okay? This is why I think girls are getting menstrual cycles at 8 years old. Because who's read this book, Skinny Bitch?
Yeah, I have.
Okay? Skinny Bitch is a great book. I didn't know that there were two vegan women. However, it brought some ideas for you to think about. If we are human, why are we drinking cow's milk? That cow produces 10 gallons of milk for her baby calf to have the biggest growth spurt within the first 2 years. But we're going to inject it with growth hormones. So instead of producing the 10 gallons a day, it's now going to make 100 gallons of milk. Do you think someone is gingerly expressing that milk out of the udders? And we're going to put on the clamps, and they're going to express the milk that way. So those of you that have breastfed, you know certain areas are very sensitive. And if it has inflammation, not only does milk come out, but something with white blood cells, pus. Okay? So what we're going to do is with the cow's milk, it has pus in it. So now we're going to have to put antibacterial agents, antiviral agents, hormones into the milk. You will see girls 12, 13, 14 years old have larger breasts than you do. Mm-hmm. There are boys, men, that are also developing mammary glands. So tell me that is not because of what kind of food we're putting into our bodies.
Not to mention all the meat, literally everything.
Okay, a strawberry. When you go strawberry picking, do you think you're going to find strawberries in nature? Right? In nature, you're lucky if you see maybe the first digit of your phalange. Natural. Organic. Right? So if you see a strawberry, that's like Frankenfood. Huh? So we are eating those hormones, those growth hormones ourselves. Okay? I'm getting to this because all of this is because of free radical damage. I teach a class about aesthetics in oncology. Cancer, when someone has cancer. Earlier I mentioned 1 out of 5 people have cancer right now, and we don't know it yet because of free radicals. Your personal care products in the shower, your shower gels, the soaps, the shampoos, everything that you're applying to your body, within 26 seconds, it's in your blood vascular system. Your body absorbs it. This is not just excreting, it's absorbing. Okay, so think of your skin like a sponge. We need to start reading. What are we putting into these bodies? Okay, awesome. All right, so we have about nutrition, the kind of food you put into your body. Let me tell you, if every meal is a dollar menu, I got news for you, there's not much nutrition. And don't even talk about, because at my house we're on a gluten-free diet. Now we're gluten-free. So there's a lot of irritable bowel syndrome. People don't even realize why they're sick, and it's because of what kind of food we're putting into our bodies every day. Okay, great. What else causes free radical damage? Who said that? I think you identify with it, huh? Who didn't have stress getting here today? I think Christine said she left before 8. So, and I'm sure you had a little bit of stress getting here today. I saw you, because when you were walking out here and you're like, how am I going to get in here now? Okay, you're here. Okay, what I'm saying is stress. You can have a set of identical twins, and one is going to look older than the other one. Maybe you have a sibling that's younger than you that is always mistaken as the older one. I'm smiling because my sister's always mistaken as the older one. So stress, you can tell on someone's face if they've lived a hard life. Free radical damage, right? Think about a homeless person, a bag lady, someone that's on the streets. That skin looks neglected, weathered, right? They got a lot of stress. Where are they going to sleep tonight? What are they going to eat? Okay. Stress is huge. What else causes free radical damage? Okay. Who said medication?
Me.
Who's me? Christine. Okay. We are over-medicated in this life. Okay. We need caffeine to get jump. That's our go-go juice in the morning. And we need
meds
to calm down. Yes. So when you are, when you have a headache, we want a quick fix. So if you have a headache, what's the first thing you want to take? An aspirin, right? But you may have a headache because you could be dehydrated. So we are over-medicated. When you are sick, you have to recover twice. One from the illness and one from the detox of the medication. Everything has a side effect. Okay? So I think we should be paying the farmer and not the pharmaceuticals. Okay? So what is Accutane? You will have clients on your facial bed with a spot on their chin and they're on Accutane. What is Accutane? Vitamin A, acne medicine that not only does it kill the sebaceous gland, it dries out all mucous membranes in your body. So not only does it dry out the oil secretion, dry mouth, dry eyes, anything that's laminated or lubricated, desert, okay? And now I have parents that their 14-year-old is sending them, me, their son, because now both of the parents have liver cancer because of years of being prescribed Accutane. So everything that you take goes through your liver, right?
Yeah.
Let's just say too many drinkies. What happens to your liver?
It starts to expand.
And how do you see it in someone's face? The yellow of the eyes. Also, you'll see an orange tint to their palms and feet. So another Chinese facial diagnosis. Because that, what's going on internally will be reflected externally. Okay? Medications, huge. We're over-medicated in this life. Who's heard of this HCG diet? What is HCG?
It's a pregnancy
hormone. So when a woman enters a pregnancy, the first trimester is her fat burning cycle. She's going to have the most banging body the first 3 months of pregnancy. That's her fat burning cycle. What's that?
I said, really?
Yeah, that's when everything's like in the right places. Okay. People that are on this HCG diet, if it is a real HCG, they are limited to 500 calories a day. So of course they're going to lose weight. That's for the whole day. And some of the side effects is that they lose handfuls of hair. So, I mean, everything has a trade-off to it, right? Yeah. So medications is huge. What's going on internally, you're going to see externally. Listen, each infusion of chemo, you're going to see in someone's nail beds. Each ridge, each infusion, you're going to see this, all right? I'm telling you this because you are going to see clients that people lie to you about retin A. People lie to you about diabetes. I had someone for 14 years who lied to me about HIV. Here I was doing his facials for 14 years. He comes into the plastic surgeon for the Botox. The doctor said, Beata, double glove. What? And he goes, double glove. And I said, okay, I'm doing the procedure. I'm blotting the blood. And after the client left, he goes, he didn't tell you he's HIV positive? I said, no, I've known him for 14 years, treating extractions and other things. People will lie to you about that.
Oh, my God, you go get tested. I would have flipped out and hit a cornea.
But, Lori, we are dealing with people's fluids. Right? What happens when you're waxing and you see the papilla and you see blood?
Right. I mean, you have gloves on, but like extraction.
You and I are wearing gloves. There are places that don't wear gloves.
Yeah. So if you always, like when you're doing the facial, are you always wearing gloves?
I'm wearing gloves for everybody. People have lied to me about too many things. I'm wearing gloves from start to end in a facial. And I've worked at the Palmer House where I just tell them, may God bless you. And I tell them right from the beginning, I wear gloves with everyone. Is that a problem? Because I need to protect myself. Okay? So people lie to you about what's going on. They don't have to tell you their whole life story. You'd like them to be honest. I had a bride lie to me about retin-A. Okay, she came to me the day before her wedding for eyebrows. I apply the warm, soft wax, fuchsia, and it's leaking serous fluid.
Oh.
Okay, now are you going to tell me what you're using? Renova. Okay, because it's the same thing as retin-A.
Right.
And she'll remember me because how do you stop that the day before her wedding? So people lie to you. Well, my coworker at Mario Tricocci, hydrocortisone and the glycolic acid was in the same container.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of reaching for the hydrocortisone, she put 20% glycolic acid on raw skin. And she could have lost her license.
Yep.
Okay? So what I'm saying is people lie about diabetes. They lie to you about We need to protect. That's why when even if you're working out of your home, you have consent forms. And I like to take pictures of everybody before and after, because I got news for you. Around the full moon, you're going to have special people come to you. Okay? And they'll be, I'm not paying for this because you broke this blood vessel. Look at this. I didn't have this capillary pop. Okay, so let's go back. Oh, my gosh. Look at your... It's there before I even touched you. And I think that is a good tool. Start taking pictures of everybody you work on. Even especially acneic people, clients, because suffering with acne, people will still fixate on that one or two instead of the 15, 20 you cleared up.
Mm-hmm.
And a picture is worth 1,000 words. So start documenting. That's part of your documentation. Start taking before and after photos. Okay? All right. So we have environment, alcohol, stress, medications, nutrition. What else?
What about exercise or the lack of that?
Who said that? Fran. All I know is that you better use it or you will lose it. Okay? So you need, when you are walking, you are moving limb. Okay? When you are sleeping, your respiration is moving limb. This is why when we resurrect, our faces look puffy in the morning. The limb. What moves blood in your body? Right. What moves limb?
Motion.
Okay. So you need to keep working. Yeah. You need to keep engaging those muscles. Okay. This is why you need water to flush out the lactic acid, the toxins, out of the body. Okay. So exercise, yes, you have to use it or you will lose it. And this is why low impact, like the yoga, is so fantastic. 1 hour massage is equal to 8 hours worth of sleep. It is indirect exercise. It releases endorphins. If you are doing...
And you need some sleep.
Oh, boy.
You're in sleep debt? You're in sleep debt?
Yeah, I'm owed.
Okay. So, sleep, I would also say, contributes to free radical damage or lack of. Ladies, the best time to get the deepest sleep is midnight to 4 a.m. This is when your body is rebuilding white blood cells. White blood cells are your T cells, your immune system. When you do not get sleep between midnight and 4 a.m., when you have an onset of a cold or flu, what's the only thing you want to do?
Sleep.
For your body to recalibrate, to rebuild the white blood cells. This is why at nighttime you want to infuse your skin, transepidermally with the most in nutrition, your most potent ingredients at nighttime, because your skin rebuilds itself between midnight and 4 a.m. Sleep is very important. Earlier I mentioned 1 hour massage is equal to 8 hours worth of sleep. If you are doing a massage on that facial client and in 10 minutes they're, you have given them a gift that they so need. We are all in sleep debt, okay? And if someone can be undressed and wearing a facial gown and you sedate them, you have given them a gift. People will remember how you made them feel, okay? Awesome. So sleep, medication, stress, alcohol, smoke, sun, environment. Okay, so what stops, repairs, and protects any more premature aging or free radical damage?
Antioxidants.
Which are your antioxidants, specifically vitamin A, vitamin C, and vitamin E. I could take a vitamin C supplement, swallow it every day. After 1 month for it to affect your skin, you're only going to get 3% benefit. You know, if you take vitamins or supplements, when you go pee pee, you're going to see a fluorescence. That's what the body thinks it doesn't need. It's excreting out the supplement. That's why we have professional grade skincare, and we're going to infuse it transepidermally. This is why all my smokers need vitamin C. Antioxidants, right? Because it's going to help. That sun goddess needs to repair the brown discolor. If I had an apple and I cut it in half, what would it look like in 4 hours?
Brown.
It ages in front of us. What do we put on the apple to prevent it from browning?
Mm-hmm.
Our vitamin C. And vitamin C will help correct hyperpigmentation, prevent any more premature aging from happening. Antioxidants. Ladies, how many of you have heard of medical needling? Okay. This is a roller. These are 30-gauge Botox needles. And this is a tool. You roll this all over the epidermis. And this is a tool to open channels to aerate the skin so that these antioxidants penetrate deeper into the skin. You cannot cause bleeding with this. Deeper needles will. So if you are interested in repairing free radical damage, you need a roller for your vitamin A, vitamin C to penetrate deeper to help repair the damage quicker. Okay? Awesome. So free radicals, let's move on. We didn't even get to our workbooks yet, huh? I got it for the body, I got it for the face, I got it for the eye area. When you are ready, Melissa, you have one, don't you? What do you think of it?
I love it.
I think it's a great tool.
Yeah, and I use it with the PCA, C, and E masks.
Good.
Love it.
So, collagen induction therapy. This is the whole line here from South Africa along the wall. This is developed by a plastic surgeon in the 1970s, Dr. Des Fernandes from the Environ line. We carry that from South Africa. And it is all vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin E based. He developed this tool in 1970s for burn victim survivors. So when someone survived a fire, what does that skin look like? Melted. Doesn't it look melted? And he found with the medical needling, if you keep rolling it, it remodels itself. Okay? So if someone has loose, flaccid skin, stretch marks, we're going to be doing the rolling. Your décolleté, your platysma, these areas age 8 years faster than our faces. Okay? If you look in the mirror one day and you're looking at your mom's chest, that's looking in the mirror because that's what's happening to you. It will happen. So how many of us moisturize? How many of us exfoliate? How many of us mask in this area? Okay, good. And if we were in Europe, the facials would include the breasts because ultimately what is the most feminine feature we have? Hello. And gravity's not working with us. Okay, good. So we have to, and so then the roller could be used in any areas that you want to firm and tighten. Okay, let's go back to the epidermis. What makes up your acid mantle? What is your acid mantle?
Water, oil.
Oh, who said that, Miss Angie?
A teacher.
What are the aesthetic terms for those two words?
Sebum.
Okay.
Well, lipids, I guess you want to call it. Lipids.
See. Sebaceous glands, sebum, and what makes up the sweat?
Sudoriferous.
Yeah, sudoriferous. So, let's just say oil and water make up something called your acid mantle, your protective barrier to your skin. If you use soaps that are very alkaline, you remove your acid mantle. These are the people that love the Dial soap, the Ivory soap, the Neutrogena, because they think that squeaky clean feeling means clean. They have destroyed their acid mantle, and 1 hour later, they have more oil than what they woke up with. It takes up to 8 hours for your body to restore its acid mantle. It takes up to 8 hours to restore acid mantle. So alkaline and base. Neutrogena Ivory Dial soap will have, on the alkaline scale, be about a 10 or 11. Comet cleanser's at an 8. They might as well be using Comet cleanser on that face than the Dial Ivory soap, Neutrogena. Okay, and that's when you see Dove, it's not pitched as a soap. What is their positioning? It's a cleansing bar. Cleansing bar. So that's closer to the pH scale, right? Earlier I mentioned about in the professional aesthetic license, we have the ability to have higher percentage of ingredients, and the most important factor is the pH of the product. What does pH stand for?
Potential of hydrogen.
Potential of hydrogen.
Come on, you gotta work with me here. Hey, I'm talking.
Okay. I want you to write down CIR.org. In your aesthetics licensure, write down what CIR.org. This stands for Cosmetic Ingredient Review. And in this Cosmetic Ingredient Review, the aesthetics licensure gives you the ability to work up to 30% in ingredients. So whether it's hydroxy acids, chemical peels, up to 30% at a pH of 4. Okay. Something OTC. OTC stands for over the counter. You're not going to have the same potency over the counter. Okay. When we go to a physician setting, we get a prescription. When you go to a dermatologist or your physician's office and they give you a prescription, you want to see a difference in your body within the next 24 to 48 hours. You want to see the most potent results possible. When you go to a salon setting, it's going to be a little bit more weaker. Maybe it's going to take two weeks to a month. But something over the counter is not really going to screw up your skin. It's really not going to help your skin either. Okay? CIR.org, Cosmetic Ingredient Review Board. Okay. I'm talking about acid mantle because what is the function of your hair follicle?
Protection.
Okay.
Girl.
I do believe that because in prehistoric time, man was covered in hair. And hair was used as protection as we have evolved. Areas that are still vulnerable, we still have hair there. Okay? So I do agree with that. What is the function? What's another function of your hair follicle? It is used as a wick to remove oil secretion to help produce your acid mantle. If we have removed the hair follicle, there is no wick. And this is why some people have breakouts after waxing, because there's still oil secretion in the pore, but there is no wick to remove it on top of the skin. So now that oil is stuck there, then you have the bacteria having an all-you-can-eat buffet on the oil secretion. You're going to send in white blood cells to kill off the infection. That is pus. And then you're going to get a nice juicy pustule. Okay. The function of your hair follicle is to be used as a wick to help remove sebaceous and sudoriferous to make up your acid mantle. Okay. Earlier we talked about acne. If you feel your chin and you feel bumps, that's a microcomedone. That's grade 1 acne. There are 4 grades of acne. So the first one is microcomedone. You'll feel that on your chin. What is the second grade of acne? Grade 2. We're going to have comedones, blackheads, and milia. What does milia look like? It looks like a piece of sand or a pearl underneath the skin, and it's closed. It's an occlusive barrier to it, okay? Grade 3, you're going to have a red spot, a papule. And when you have white blood cells, you have a juicy pustule. And then 4 are going to be the nodules and cysts. Maybe you may not see them, but if you would press on it, you could feel the pressure within, okay? If we have waxed somebody and we see the papilla, this is why some people have little milia breakouts, maybe on their upper lip, or maybe they'll see it on their eyebrows. Or if you do a guy's back, you know that they're going to break out within 24 to 48 hours. You have removed the wick from that surface. I'm saying this because in dermaplaning, not only are we removing dead skin cells, we're going to disturb hair. The hair follicle. Okay, so that's why we're addressing this now. Okay, so let's open up our books. The first page, dermaplaning. Dermaplaning, sometimes known as epidermal leveling or blading, is a non-invasive skin rejuvenation treatment designed to make the skin feel smoother and to appear healthier and more youthful. This is like a manual microdermabrasion. Like microdermabrasion, dermaplaning removes the topmost layer of skin, thus eliminating dead skin cells and minor surface imperfections. 95% of all the dust in our homes are human skin cells. We produce 5 billion skin cells a day. Someone that has a skin disorder, like acne, eczema, psoriasis, ichthyosis, seborrhea. They are missing vitamin A or lamellar granules to maintain proper skin thickness. That acneic skin is producing 4 to 5 times as many skin cells a day. Okay? So this is with skin disorders. They are producing more skin cells than are being abraded or dissolved every day. Yes. Cindy, in the Environ line, Dr. Des Fernandez recommends vitamin A, anyone 6 months old, for the rest of your life. Vitamin A, not to peel the skin, but it helps stimulate fibroblast activities of collagen and elastin. It maintains proper skin thickness. Internally, what we're going to do is increase beta carotene. Yellow, orange, red fruits and vegetables. I would rather do that than to be supplementing it. So, yes, definitely vitamin A maintains proper skin thickness. Well, let's go there, Cindy. What else? What ingredient in aesthetics also help dissolve skin cells? Thank you, Melissa. Pineapple and papaya work like Pac-Man. They will dissolve dead proteolytic skin cells. If I was in Hawaii and my job was to pick pineapples, I would have no fingerprints. Okay? It will dissolve skin cells. That is fantastic. What is another ingredient that will dissolve skin cells? Papain and bromelain, pineapple. Okay. That is very rich in vitamin A. Okay. So what else is a hydroxy acid that I'm thinking about?
Alpha hydroxy acid.
Not alpha.
Beta hydroxy acid.
Thank you for saying that. When we're talking about chemical peels, we have an alpha. Think of a brick wall. What keeps the bricks together?
Mortar.
Or cement. Alpha hydroxy acids will dissolve the mortar, the cement, but the bricks, the skin cells are still there. It's the beta hydroxy acids that will dissolve skin cells. So this is why someone with acne, you're going to see them on salicylic acid. 2% or higher has to be given by a prescription. It will dissolve skin cells. Okay? Good. Someone with acneic skin is going to have salicylic acid. Good. Basics of dermaplaning. Dermaplaning treatments, a form of manual exfoliation or manual microderm, are typically performed by a dermatologist or a licensed esthetician at a professional skincare center. Dermaplaning, or epidermal leveling, utilizes a sterile surgical blade called a dermatome. This dermatome is carefully stroked over the skin in even motion similar to shaving. Treatment time can be short as 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, so Oscar Wilde wrote that a man's face is an autobiography and a woman's face is a work of fiction. What do men do on a daily basis?
Shave.
This is why they don't decay overnight like women do. They're doing their dermaplaning every day. Okay? There are some real housewives that do their dermaplaning. Okay? Women in Germany get their faces waxed not to remove the hair, but to remove skin cells. When you use soft wax, what happens to the texture of the skin? You could see the difference, couldn't you? Okay. So think of this as another manual exfoliation. Okay. Treatment can be as short as 15, 20 minutes. In a physician's office, some dermatologist's office will leave a bottle of rubbing alcohol at the sink. Tell the patient, go ahead, remove your makeup, use the rubbing alcohol, and they just get on the bed. And the nurse or the esthetician will blade their skin, and thank you very much. Okay? Very interesting. There are some physician offices that use acetone. What is acetone? Thank you. And so they'll use that because you need to degrease. You want to dry out the skin as much as possible. I would prefer to use a 5% salicylic acid. I also have cherry-scented rubbing alcohol for you to use this afternoon as well. I'm saying about beta-hydroxy acid because at a school that Millie and I were from, Image has this prepping solution. So I thought, oh, this is going to be a great way to prep the skin from dermaplaning. No, it had glycolic acid, which is a humectant. So it hydrated the skin, which was absolutely useless for the dermaplaning. You want to keep the skin as dry as possible to make it a better treatment. So 5% prepping solution that's just salicylic acid. Or you can use a rubbing alcohol. And if you really don't like the client, you'll use the acetone. Okay? So, bleeding the skin painlessly removes dry, dead surface skin to reveal new, healthier skin cells. Dermaplaning poses no serious side effects, and patients can resume normal activities immediately following the treatment. Typically, dermaplaning is only performed on the face. We're going to avoid the orbicularis oculi muscle, and we're going to avoid the nose, and we're not going to go past the curves. Okay, so anything here. Well, what does it treat? This will treat dry, rough skin, acne scars, uneven skin tone, large pores, fine lines, even unwanted facial hair. Dermaplaning is safe, effective treatment for overall skin rejuvenation. This can produce a smoother skin surface and a clearer complexion while minimizing fine lines and minor scars. Since we're using a sharp blade, unwanted peach fuzz or whiskers can also be eliminated during the treatment. In this manner, dermaplaning offers a rare combination of skin rejuvenation and facial hair removal benefits. There are two types of hair that grow on our bodies. Vellus hair, the peach fuzz, our tiny translucent blonde hair, and terminal hair. Terminal hair is the thicker hair that grows under the arms, in the pubic area, eyebrows, mustache, beards for men, and on the legs.
I have a question.
Yes.
Can you do this on pregnant people and kids?
So, if, thank you, we're going to get there, Cindy,
oh,
but
okay.
Since you brought it up, you absolutely can do this on pregnant women. I would maybe eliminate the hydroxy acid because that's still absorbed by the mom, whether she's breastfeeding or carrying the baby. Number two, in the third trimester, you need to have the bed raised up because she can no longer lay flat because it'll put pressure on the vena cava, the blood supply to the baby. So you just have to have them elevated and no chemicals, no hydroxy acids on their skin. What did you ask about children?
Can you do it on
them too? Typically, I'll see people 14 and up. If they're under 18, I have the parents in the room with me. And you better have an adult, a guardian with you. But I've only done this people typically 35 years and older. I would never do this on a male skin because they have more oil than we do. Male skin is thicker and a lot more oilier. This is why they age slower. Okay. So, did I answer your question?
So you can't do this on men.
You know, I've done it on people that are transgender, that they were once, but with the hormone therapies, now I can. Right. Because that's terminal hair. We're not going to disturb terminal hair. Good point, terminal hair. So, in Chinese facial diagnosis, your upper lip hair correlates to the hair in the fallopian tubes. Okay? There is cilia to help with the ovulation. Yeah, there's hair in the fallopian tubes. Mm-hmm. It's called cilia. I'll take you to cadaver lab with me.
No, it's okay.
The inside of the intestines are velvety soft.
I've already been.
Okay.
Myself.
Okay.
No desire.
So as women, we're losing estrogen every day. As we are losing estrogen, testosterone levels, adult acne starts to happen. Not only with more testosterone breakouts happen, terminal hair happens. And this is where you see terminal hair, the ones that look like black wires. They're going to start to come in areas that no longer came before. Because you're hot stuff, Melissa. Okay, so terminal hair, if you see terminal hair, do not disturb it. Because if you blade it, you better have a laser, and they better sign up for laser. because now you're going to start to induce that growth cycle. Next page. Vellus hair, when cut or removed, will grow back the same way. The structure of the hair does not become damaged and therefore impossible to alter. Terminal hair is physiologically coarse. When terminal hair is cut, it grows back the same way, coarse. Sometimes waxing can make the hair appear to be thinner, but it's not any thinner at all. Because waxing pulls the hair by its root, the new hair grows in with a smoother tip, making it feel softer, but it's actually the same type of hair it was before. It's only when we cut the hair, any type of hair, that it grows back with the same blunt cut at the tip. Acne scars and minor wrinkles can be minimized with dermaplaning as the blade removes damaged epidermal skin. Since dermaplaning removes dead skin more swiftly and cleanly than the natural shedding process allows, it also triggers a speedier skin cell turnover. This treatment, when professionally trained, is extremely safe. There is no more risk to the skin than when a man shaves his face. As long as the practitioner has adequate training, the treatment should be very easy and quick. It could be performed every 3 to 4 weeks, no sooner than that. Blading the skin actually removes about 2 to 3 weeks worth of dead skin. The skin should complete its normal skin cycle in approximately 30 days. Sometimes the skin peels after dermaplaning. After the procedure is done every 2 weeks, then the skin cycle has not had a chance to be completed. Thus, you're blading skin that has not had the need to be peeled yet, and peeling can occur. Also, if using a chemical peel after, you can experience some superficial peeling. But the idea is not to over-exfoliate the skin. The idea is to assist in the skin's natural exfoliation process. Okay? So think of this as your exfoliation method. So you can have enzymes, you can have hydroxyethylene, you may have microderm abrasion. Did I bring a dermophile to your classroom?
I don't think so.
This is also, what's that? So I'll pass that around. Millie, you have one, don't you?
No, I don't.
Oh, you should. Anyone that has enzymes, that is a great tool to buff the skin, pushing the enzymes. Earlier, we were talking about microdermabrasion in this crosshatch movement. That will help move dead skin cells. Sometimes, dermophile. So some people have those bumps on their upper arms. So, actually, that's not even bad. In Chinese medicine, that means someone's holding on to their uric acid, that they're holding on to their, they don't pee-pee enough.
Oh, I'm holding it right now.
Okay. So, see how much you're learning from me, Cindy? See how much you're learning from me?
Wait, what would you do with this? You'd put the enzyme on and then you just...
Yeah, or you can just do it right now. Yeah, you it's a file, and it abrades dead skin. So, if someone has built up skin. I love using this with my enzymes because it helps remove anything that could be left on the skin. Okay, dermaplaning versus microdermabrasion. Cindy, go bathroom. Go around. I'm telling you because when we get older, your bladder is like a balloon. And you're going to sneeze and you're going to laugh and you're going to squirt. So go around. So go. Make your lap around, turn right, turn right, turn right. Turn right, turn right, turn right, turn right, turn right. Okay, microdermabrasion versus dermaplaning. Microderm has long been one of the top non-surgical treatments for skin rejuvenation. And while dermaplaning and microdermabrasion address most of the same skin issues, the treatment mechanism and the effects are slightly different. Rather than dermaplaning with the blade, microdermabrasion exfoliates the surface with a pressurized stream of abrasive crystals. Both treatments should be performed by an aesthetic professional to yield the best results. Because dermaplaning uses a sharp blade, it is also considered a more aggressive form of exfoliation than microdermabrasion. Prominent acne scars and wrinkles can be better treated with dermaplaning. However, the potential for nicks and cuts during dermaplaning also create the possibility of bleeding or skin infection post-treatment. More manual skill is usually required on the part of the dermaplane treatment provider. To be honest with you, what happens is most of my nurses do not have this aesthetic touch. And so they just got to get it done. Thank you, Millie. And so they are more harsh with the scalpel. And as long as you keep a 45 degree angle, when you wax, how do you apply wax?
45.
There you go. So before each one of you start blading, you're going to show me what you, do you found it? You found,
yeah,
it?
I found it?
Okay. Each one of you will show me what you think is a 45 degree angle. And when I correct you, then you can go ahead and blade the skin. All right? Next page. Microdermabrasion treatments can cause different exfoliation crystals for customized treatment results. Since there's less chance that microdermabrasion can break the skin, it also, they argued that microdermabrasion is safer, lower risk treatment of the two. I remember in 1999, microdermabrasion was too radical. They're doing it in Europe and at Dermalogica, Beata, this is too aggressive. Sure, if I kept a microdermabrasion on the same spot for 15, 20 seconds, what's going to happen? You're going to get pinhole bleeding too, right? Okay, so you got to keep it moving. And I remember in 1999, because of the aluminum crystals, aluminum was linked to Alzheimer's. Okay, so there are microdermabrasion machines that have baking soda. You can have different types of crystals. I think the best one is just the diamond tip. Just the diamond tip, and I think it's more cost effective because you're going to have to keep buying the crystal, and then what do you do with the dead crystals? Okay. All right. In terms of cost, dermaplaning can be slightly higher than microdermabrasion, although specific pricing can vary by region and skincare provider. Microdermabrasion is about $100 per treatment, while dermaplaning can be anywhere from $50 to $200. This is my exfoliation. So earlier we read about how I cannot do dermaplaning on the nose. I cannot do it. So I could still use perhaps my diamond tip, and I'll abrade those areas. Okay, work those areas as well. Or pull out your microdermabrasion and you can work the décolleté, your platysma, eye area as well. Microdermabrasion, it's within 10, 15 minutes. Those of you that have used crystals, what happens? The client has souvenirs, don't they?
Yes.
So around the hairline, maybe you left some in the ear, maybe around the eye area. With dermaplaning, you're not going to have that. If anything, you're going to have a collection of their DNA, and they're going to be fascinated what came off of their skin. Benefits of dermaplaning. It allows for increased absorption and penetration of skincare products, making them more effective. It increases the cell turnover. It increases collagen and elastin production. This is the best treatment for the best dermis. The client's skin will be glowing, healthy, radiant skin. Yes, please. It improves uneven pigmentation, such as sunspots and melanin. It decreases the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. Yes, please. Improves the texture of the skin. Oh, skin has a healthy, radiant glow. Increases skin hydration. Those of us that wear mineral makeup, usually mineral makeup is suspended over the vellus here. Once we've dermaplaned the skin, the makeup adheres to the true canvas, okay? So it's gonna adhere to the skin. This is very popular from April through October because those of us that are in the sun, the vellus hair can glimmer in the sun, right? So we're gonna remove that. Contraindications, who should not receive dermaplaning? Someone that has grades 3-4 acne, so someone with the papules, the cysts. Cindy asked earlier about ages, so I usually do this from 35 years and up, someone who does not suffer with adult acne. earlier we talked about menopause, so someone with a drier skin is really going to benefit from the dermaplaning. Skin cancer, active cold sores, you know, even microdermabrasion can be seen as an irritant. So those of us that are prone to these, I always bring acyclovir, which is a medication to prevent or suppress an eruption from happening. Okay. Uncontrolled diabetes, dermatitis, any skin lesions, anyone using Accutane, that's that prescription for acne, because it dries out mucous membranes and the skin is so dry to begin with. Okay. All right, next page. 20 more minutes. You can do it. 20 more minutes through this. After microdermabrasion, what is the chief complaint for the first 24 to 48 hours?
Redness.
And what else?
Dryness.
Dehydration. So whether it's microdermabrasion or dermaplaning, the client needs to go home with a vitamin B5. Vitamin B5 is panthenol. Vitamin B5 serum is like giving your skin a glass of water. We all need that. We're all dehydrated. So a B5 gel is what they should be doing every day. Even if they're oily acneic skin, oil and water are two different things. Okay? Vitamin B5. And that is like giving your skin a glass of water. So, this page, dermaplaning safety guidelines, if they're pregnant, if they're breastfeeding, you can have to do an acid-free dermaplaning without acetone or hydroxyacids. So the 5%, no salicylic, nothing with chemicals, because that will get passed on to mom and baby.
So would you just use the alcohol?
You can use alcohol because it'll evaporate quickly. I would stay away from the acetone. Facial surgery, so let's just say they had their wisdom teeth done, maybe they've had some work done. We just want to wait until all the edema, any swelling is gone. TCA peel, we want to wait 4 to 6 weeks post-laser. Actually, we would do dermaplaning right before photofacial and laser hair removal. If I am doing laser, I want to make sure there is no hair for the laser to target. We want, when we're doing laser, what do you want the laser to target?
The
papilla.
Yeah, the root.
And so if you have skin hair on top of the skin, it's going to singe it. You're going to smell the aroma of burnt hair. It's not going to be as effective. Okay? So we would actually dermaplane before IPL photofacials. We will do it. That's why you have to have shaving or trimming done within 24 hours of hair removal. Electrolysis, 7 days before or after. Waxing and depilatory creams, dermaplanings don't mix because waxing has to be done every 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks. Fillers, Botox, your injectables. You can do dermaplaning right before. You would be the first person that they see. And then they can get their injectables. If they got injected, we cannot disturb their area for up to 2 weeks because you're going to migrate the product and make it go where it's not supposed to go. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So we, not that we're nosy, but we don't want to contribute to sabotaging them. Okay, protocols for dermaplaning. We're going to cleanse this. We're going to do prepping, skin prep. So if you are really oily, I have acetone for you. I do have rubbing alcohol. I have 5% salicylic acid. Evaluate the skin. Do an assessment. Avoid areas present that can limit the use of dermaplaning. Maybe they scratch themselves in their sleep. Maybe they have some something going on. We're going to avoid areas that we should not. In this treatment, you will not use your steamer at all. No steam. We don't want to soften the skin. And there are some clinics that will start dermaplaning while you still have your makeup. on. We are not going to disturb the eye area, so you don't have to worry about messing up their mascara, their eyeliners. And we're going to perform the dermaplaning.
I have a question.
Cindy.
You can do this on after, but what if they're open?
We're not going to, so show me where someone has acne. Maybe they have it maybe on their cheek area. We're going to do everything but. We're not going to abrade that area. But that tells me that maybe they're not maybe they're too young to be getting dermaplaned. If that happens, high frequency. What is high frequency? There are two gases. There's ozone, argon, and neon gas. So purple is going to be germicidal. The orange is going to help push products deeper into the skin. If you use high frequency electrode over that skin, it prevents breakouts from happening. You should do this with your waxing clients. At Mario Tricocci, anytime that we had a bikini waxing, we had to do high frequency because it prevents ingrown hair. It prevents eruptions from happening. Okay, so high frequency is a great tool to have. Performing dermaplaning, the skin is tight and the blade is light. Patient must not move or talk. You have a scalpel over them, so if they're a chatty, we gotta zip it. And I always tell them, you're going to sneeze or you're going to cough, let me know, because I have a scalpel over you. Hold the skin taut between the index finger and thumb. So each one of you is going to show me what you think your index finger and thumb is. Just like microderm abrasion, don't you need to taut the skin? You need to support the skin, so whatever you're going to stretch out. Listen, someone in their 70s, 80s is going to have very flaccid, loose skin. You need to support that so that you get the best exfoliation on them. Hold the knife handle firmly. So we're not going to hold it like it's a makeup brush. We're going to hold to make sure that that scalpel handle, this is what it's going to feel like, so pass that around. You want to make sure that it feels good in your hands and it's no chance of you dropping it. Bring the instrument towards you, scraping the skin lightly across the skin between the index finger and thumb. Keep the blade on the surface of the skin as you bring it back to the starting point. With moderate strokes, you're going to go half an inch to an inch thick passes. You are not going to go more than four passes because now you've removed the stratum disjunctum. That's why three to four times in the same area. We will start on the forehead and pick a side to work on. Stretch the skin under each eye, each finger away from the eye, bringing the skin down towards the malar prominence of the cheeks. I'm also going to pass around two sizes of blades, a 15 blade. Well, I'll pass the envelope maybe. I don't want the blade. A 15 and a 10 blade. A 15 blade, I don't know if you can see, that's how big a 15 blade is. And when I first started dermaplaning, it took me an hour to do someone's face because look how small the blade is. Okay? So a 10 blade, did I pass that around? So you're going to cover more area faster. This would be great around what? Thank you. So this is going to be better work tool in these areas. Okay. All right. So the jawline is stretched between the finger and thumb, then pulled towards the jawbone. The corner of the mouth is best scraped, having the patient open their mouth wide and scraping in a north-south. You know, sometimes I'll even have them put their tongue underneath, or they can just open wide. And then if they are prone to cold sores, this perioral area, they will only do one pass. This is not a hair removal technique, and I'm saying this because I had a special person on New Year's Eve come to me who cannot be waxed, and she wanted to remove some of the vellus hair. An hour later, she's in the mirror, but you missed this one here. And you missed this one here. And three blades later, I said, we're done. We are done because after four passes, you can make someone have some redness because you're overstimulating that skin. So do not, that is a benefit, but I would not position it. Okay, thank you. All right, actually, I'll put the 15 blade on here. Each one of you will practice how to put blades on with me here so that you feel comfortable doing that before we get into the hands-on. So controlling the dermaplaning, always use a number three handle. That's a stainless steel number three handle, never disposable. Have the face thoroughly degreased. We want to have no trace of oil or moisture on the skin. It has to be extremely dry. Hold the skin taut between your index finger and thumb. You're going to start at a 45 degree angle, never losing contact with the skin. Dermaplaning until you finish the work area. Always move between your index finger and thumb of your non-operating hand. And you operate with no pressure. The blade is light and the skin is tight. When you finish, dust away the dead skin cells away from the face and out of the hairline and discard the blade in the proper waste receptacle. Okay?
Is that like the same thing that the needles go in? Like
Sharps container. Thank you. We have Sharps containers that will deposit the blades in. All right, so this will give you some directions. Let's go to safety hints. Always keep the blade at a 45 degree angle. So a right angle is 90 degree angle. We're going to keep it, this is 45. And earlier I mentioned, just like with waxing, you're going to hold it at a 45 degree angle the whole time. If you keep it at a 90, what's going to happen to the skin? And you're going to have a bleeder.
Yeah.
And we don't want bleeders today. Okay, it's not going to look cute on your portfolio that you had a bleeder. That usually happens with my nurses. My nurses are very heavy-handed. All right, so this will just give you a roadmap how we're going to do the forehead, the cheek area, the perioral area. When we're going to come back from lunch, we're going to do, I'll demonstrate the dermaplaning, then I'll have you broken up into groups. You have to give and you have to receive. What we're going to do is cleanse the skin twice, whether it's with a rubbing alcohol, a salicylic acid, a prepping solution. Each one of you, before you start, will show me what you think is a 45 degree angle. And you'll go ahead and blade the skin. Afterwards, we're going to pass something called tissue repair. Did we talk about tissue? You remember tissue? I love tissue repair. So tissue repair is for skin that, first of all, may feel like a sunburn. Maybe like if you've dry shaved before, what do your legs feel? So you have the irritation, inflammation. That's a burn.
That's insane. So it's like for sunburn?
This, tissue repair, insect bites, sunburns, anything that causes itching, inflammation, it gets rid of fungus in someone's nail beds. It gets rid of cold sores. If someone is carrying a baby, it prevents stretch marks from happening. It repairs stretch marks. Yes. So everybody should have this, even after waxing.
Yeah.
Don't you think it would be great to have in your back bar? Tissue repair. I use this with everyone. I do. Thank you for saying that because, you know, today, if there's anything that you like, even the Environ that goes for $112, you will get everything today at half off at the wholesale price if you're ready. Okay? So, you know, I think of these as just tools and we're not making any, we just want to get you the right tools. Okay, so we're going to cleanse the skin twice. We're going to blade the skin. We're going to put the tissue repair on, and that will be our experience today. I think after your second, third dermaplaning, you guys are going to rock it. I think it's a new experience to hold a scalpel in your hands, and I remember Crystal saying that You're already shaky, right?
I'm always shaky.
Listen, I'm shaky too, okay? But I think if you are confident, the client will feel that. Because even in your massage movements, how you feel, the person interprets that.
Like when I'm working, I'm fine. But to like sit here, like you can see.
Yeah.
And when I'm working and I'm good.
Yeah. And it's all good. So you have to feel good about this. Yeah. You guys are going to rock it. It's going to be all good. All right? Listen, I'd rather have you work and have an experience here. Whoever doesn't have a partner has to do it on me. So maybe you'll have to work on me. All right.
I have another question.
Yes, Cindy.
Is it good for psoriasis?
Yes, it is. Psoriasis. Thank you for bringing this up. In Greek, psoriasis are wounds that weep. What are boys taught not to do? Boys don't
cry.
Okay. But the psoriasis weeps. Okay. Psoriasis, you're born with it. And it goes away when you hit puberty, and it comes back in your late 20s, early 30s. It's the onset of the seasons when you are under extreme stress, whether it's physical or emotional. But enzymatics help with that.
My husband has it around his hairline.
Okay, so that would help. But also enzymes can help with that, and the vitamin B5. Okay? Yes. So we talked about dermatitis. They are missing glomerular granules that make vitamin A, enzymes, salicylic acid. That's going to help maintain proper. Okay. All right. All right. Let's go ahead and break for a 1-hour lunch.